Welcome everyone. My name is Pramod Beesal, IIT Delhi graduate and currently an RSME officer, 2017 batch. Today we are going to discuss about the simple geometrical transformations in 2D as well as in 3D. Okay. 2D part is basically for gate purpose only and 3D part is for ESE. Okay. Anyways, we will be discussing 2D so that you can make your base and your concept regarding 3D also by taking the clues from 2D itself. Okay. It will help you remembering the formulas. So the very first and the basic transformation that we have is, as usual, the translation. Okay. So we may have translation of point. So first, the category that we are discussing of transformations is where the absolute coordinates remain same. Okay. We are not changing the absolute coordinates. So when we are having a translation in 2D, the problem will be something like this. Okay. So this is my current point x comma y, and this is my new point x dash comma y dash, and I have translated it dx along x axis and dy along y axis. Okay, so what I can say here that y dash will be equal to x plus dx, x dash will be equal to x plus dx and y dash will be equal to y plus dy, right? So that is the basic transformation equation we can have for two-dimensional transformation. Okay, if the similar problem was there in 3D, then x dash would have been equal to x plus dx, y dash would have been equal to y plus dy, and z dash would have been equal to z plus dz, whatever transformation that we have in z direction. Okay. Now, the second basic transformation is rotation. Okay. So rotation and translation, usually we will have questions from these two only, but anyways, we are going to look at other basic transformations also in order to have a complete idea of transformations. Okay. So when I say rotation, let's say this is my problem. And as I said, we are going to keep the coordinate system same. So xy remains same, meaning if initially I was having this point P here with coordinates x comma y. Okay. Now I have rotated this point with respect to the origin itself to a new point P dash, which is x dash comma y dash. Okay, so what I'm doing here, I'm keeping my coordinate system definition same, but changing the point definition, right? My point is changing actually, and I'm rotating it with angle theta anti-clockwise. Okay, the anti-clockwise angle we take as positive here. Okay, anti-clockwise angle is to be taken as positive with respect to our formula. If we have count this clockwise rotation, then we can take minus theta in there. That's not an issue. Okay. So here, let's say if the length of this OP or OP dash is R, and initially it was having an angle phi with respect to it, right? So X would be equal to R cos phi and Y will be equal to R sine phi, right? I'm just giving this brief, this derivation so that you will be able to understand and retain the formula. So x dash now I can say will be equal to r cos of theta plus phi, right? Theta plus phi. And y dash will be equal to r sine of theta plus phi, right? Now I can expand it. So cos theta gives me what? R cos a cos b, right? And minus r sine a sine b. Similarly, this will give me R sin A cos B minus R cos A sin B. Okay. And then I can implement this thing here, put it here. Then I will get X dash is equal to X cos theta minus Y sin theta. Okay. And Y dash will be equal to X sin theta plus y sin theta. Okay, so this is the basic transformation equation that I can get with simple geometrical analysis, right? As we did in our this 2D and 3D translation also. Okay, so this was for two dimension. If I talk about three dimensional rotation, okay, then in three dimension the same problem, I can say that this is rotation about z axis, okay, the vertical axis. If I want to write it in a simple format, then what we use here, something called as matrix form. Okay, matrix of it. So the matrix I can write here is x dash y dash is equal to, I can say, cos theta minus sine theta, cos theta into x y. Okay, so if I have my old coordinates and if I'm keeping my coordinate system same at the same place, then my new coordinates will be given by this particular transformation. Okay, so that is for 2D. Now if I talk about 3Ds, then in 3D the transfer, the rotation about z axis with theta angle, so the equation is this matrix is going to remain same. Okay, so that matrix will be same only, cos theta minus sine theta cos theta, and other ones will become 0, 0 and 1. So that is the rotation matrix with respect to z axis. Okay, so z axis we can write the rotation matrix and we can remember it with the help of two dimensional rotation. When I say rotation with respect to y, okay, if I'm keeping the theta angle there only, okay, and then it will become cos theta 0 sine theta 0 1 0 minus sine theta 0 cos theta. Okay, so this one, these things you can remember directly, because it if question comes then you will need to apply these formulas there, okay, right away. So you can remember them, it will be helpful for you. Okay, again for x 0 0 0 0, okay, and then here again cos theta sine theta sine theta cos theta. Okay, so that is the basic transformation matrix, this rotation matrix in three dimension. Okay, so the third transformation that we can have is scaling. Scaling is basically we are increasing or reducing the size. Okay, for example, if this were my initial any object or any geometry initially, so let's say this distance is w old or old width, and this is my h old, the old height. Now I have changed its scale and I have enlarged it, okay, such that this becomes something like this. Okay, so this becomes my w nu, okay, and this becomes my h nu. Okay, so depending upon the transformation that I'm applying, either in x direction or in y direction or in both directions, the size of this particular geometry will change. Okay, so I can have simply a x scale. Okay, in that case sx will be equal to simply w nu divided by w old, or I can say x nu divided by x old. Simply, we don't have to worry about it, right? X nu divided by x old, that will give me sx, that is scale in x direction. So my x nu is basically nothing but sx into x old, okay, that width. Similarly, h nu will be equal to sy into y old, right, or the old height. So that is the scaling if we apply that in two dimension, means along x, along y, both of them if I are applying, and then I can put this particular equation into a matrix form, and that would be x dash y dash is equal to sx 0 0 sy, and there I am going to have my old coordinates. So I can get my new coordinates after the scaling factor in this form, in a matrix form. Okay, now if I am having, this was what, 2D, if I am having the same thing in 3D, then what will happen in 3D and how will that equation look like? Okay, so I might have a scaling factor along z also. So sx 0 0 0 sy 0 0 sz, that is going to be my scaling matrix along three dimension system. Okay, so such scaling I can have. So the fourth transformation that we can have is shearing. Okay, so if I look at a two dimensional object, okay, when I'm having only two dimensions, and let's say this is my I will be using four points just to understand the concept of shearing here better. Okay, so this is my initial shape that is undergoing shear along either x or along y or along both of the axes. Okay, so when it is going under shear along x axis, so x shear means it is going to get shear in this direction. Okay, so the y will remain same, but the x coordinate will change over here. Okay, so that is going to be my new shape along the x shear. If I am having a y shear, then because of y shear, it will be, these coordinates are going to remain same, and I am giving this force to it. Okay, so that will be the final force over here, the final shape over here. Okay, so that will be because of y shear. Again, I can have both the shears together, right? XY shear. Okay, So in case of xy shear, I will be basically having this also changed and this also changed, right? And these will be my 4 points after both the shears, after x shear as well as y shear both shears. Okay, now when I'm giving an x shear, if I talk about this point only, I can say that my x nu or the x dash, okay, x dash will be equal to x plus whatever the shear that was acting along y, along x into y, old y is here, okay, and my y dash is equal to y only. At the same time here, y dash is equal to y plus shear along y direction into x, and my x dash is same only, okay. That is what I am going to have here. And if I am applying both of them, then x dash is equal to x plus shear along x into y, and y dash will be equal to y plus shear along y into x. Okay, so these things, these equations I will be having for my new coordinates. Now again, I can represent them in form of a matrix. So here I can say that this is somehow equal to 1 sx 0 1. Okay, this is something like 1 sy 0 1, and this is almost equal to 1 sx sy and 1. Okay, so that's how I can represent the shear in two dimension. Okay, at the same time, if I'm having shear in three dimensions, then I can have a three dimensional equation also. But there also, here I was having shear along some axis, and there I will be having shear along some plane, and the 2D or like 2x2 matrix will convert into a 3x3 matrix, right? So the first case that I can have there is xy plane shear. Okay, then I can have xz, and then I can have yz, right? Anyways, you don't need to remember the three-dimensional shear formulas, but I'm just giving you them for a idea basically. Okay, so here x and y are given 0 sx 0 1 sy 0 0 1. Okay, and it is x and z and given sx 0 0 1 0 0 sz and 1, and when it is yz, we will be 1 0 0 sy 1 0 sz 0 1. Okay, and whatever is 0 out of them, we can put that as 0 and use our equation. So this is 3D shear. Okay, that is how we write the 3D shear. So we have talked about translation, we have talked about rotation, we have talked about scaling, and we have talked about shearing. Okay, now the last this transformation that we have is about reflection. Okay, so we can have reflection of a point into another plane. Okay, so final thing is reflection. Actually, reflection is usually asked in gate only, it has nothing to do with our ES. Okay, so reflection when we talk about the reflection, reflection could be taken about any axis, okay, about any plane or about any independent line also. Okay, so let's say I am having this object, okay, and I want to know its reflection along x-axis. So along x-axis, we all know, I mean, we can reproduce the axis geometries here. So this is going to be my reflection here, right? Similarly, at the same time, if I want y-axis reflection, then let's say this is my initial shape and I want to have a y-axis reflection. So it will come something like this, right? This point is coming up here, right? Then we can have some other reflections also, and that will include mainly the main ones are, this is x reflection, right? This is y reflection, and now we can have reflection about origin. Okay, so reflection about origin, what do we mean by that? Let's say I am having this triangle here, okay, and it is getting reflected through the origin. So with respect to the origin, I will be having this sort of reflection to it. Okay, then other reflections, I mean, like just like the basic reflections only about line x is equal to y. Okay, so this is my line x is equal to y. Okay, and I can have a reflection about this also. Okay, so let's say this is my point, and then it will get reflected here, right? So these sort of reflections we can have. Now, to represent all these reflections, what we can do is we can simply take one point, write its reflection in our mind and make the equation first, and then do the transformation onto something else. Okay, so for example, when I'm doing x reflection and my point is, example here is 3, 4. Okay, 3, 4 is my point that I want to reflect with respect to x-axis. So let's say this is 3, 4. So when I am I going to reflect this point into this, my x value is going to remain same, right? X reflection, my x dash is going to remain same and y dash will become minus y, right? So I can right away say that reflection will be 3, -4. Okay, I hope that you don't have any problem in that. If I want to represent it in terms of matrix, then I will say 1, 0, 0, -1 will give me the transformation matrix. Okay, it is going to give me the transformation matrix. Similarly, when I talk about y reflection, so same point, 3, 4 only. 3, 4 point, I want to reflect along the y-axis. So I know that y is going to remain same and x is going to become minus x. So it will become -3, 4. And transformation matrix, I can say, it's -1, 0, 0, 1. Okay, there is a transformation matrix. If I want to transform it along the origin, okay, so along the origin both the points are getting negated here, okay, so 3, 4 will become -3, -4. Okay, so x dash is equal to minus x and y dash is equal to minus y. -3, -4 it will become, and in matrix I can say 1, -1, 0, 0, -1. That's what a matrix I will be having here. Okay, and when I'm reflecting it with respect to x is equal to y line, okay, so x is equal to y line, 3, 4 will become 4, 3. So x dash basically becomes y and y dash will become x. So it will become 4, 3, and the matrix representation would be 0, 1, 1, 0. Okay, so in that way we can do most of the reflections just by taking one example and then doing the geometrical reflection there and then itself. Okay, we can have reflections in 3D also, but let's not talk about the reflections in 3D. We will keep our discussion till here only. Now let's look at the questions to apply our concepts here. Okay, so the first question is from prelims 2019, and it says that there is a vector 5y 3z 8k, and it has to be rotated by an angle 90 degree about x-axis. Okay, so what we need to do, we first need to identify the rotation matrix about x-axis. Okay, and that is 1, 0, 0, 0, 0 and cos theta minus sin theta and cos theta, right? That is the matrix we have, rotation matrix. Okay, so what I will be having, that v nu or my nu vector will be equal to the rotation matrix, that is theta is equal to 90 degrees. Okay, so it will become 1, 0, 0, 0, and that is cos 90 minus sin 90, 0 sin 90 and cos 90, right, into 5, 3 and 8, and that is my matrix that I am having here. Okay, and when I do the calculations here and when I solve it, I will get 5, -8 and 3. Okay, and that is the final answer, 5, -8, 3. See this last one here, no? That we will see in our homogeneous transformation matrix. Okay, that we'll have a look at that later. Okay, now, okay, so if we are having a point 2, 5 and we want to rotate it by 90 degree about the origin, then about the origin the equation will be cos theta minus sin theta cos theta into the coordinates of the current point, and that will give me -5, 2. Okay, now there is one more question here which says circle of radius 10 having center at 1, 4 is translated by 5 units along x. Okay, means dx is equal to 5 and 1 unit along y, and dy is equal to 1, what will be the new center coordinates? Okay, so we are only asked the center coordinates here. We need not worry about the radius. Anyways, when we are simply translating a circle from one point to another point, the radius will not have any effect on it, and it will also not change. Okay, so we are not bothered about that. So initially the coordinates are 1, 4. After applying this particular transformation here, okay, so I know that x dash will be equal to x plus dx, right, and that will be equal to 1 plus 5, means 6, and y dash will be equal to y plus dy, and that will be equal to 4 plus 1, means 5. So my new coordinates will be 6, Fine. Okay. So that is how we can apply the rotation as well as the translation, and all those basic concepts will be applied with the help of some formulas. Okay. Now here let's have one more question. We say triangle with coordinates 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1 is rotated by 30 degrees anti-clockwise about the origin. What are new vertex coordinates? Okay, one more thing. If you are not, if it is not mentioned that whether it is anti-clockwise rotation or clockwise rotation, that we are going to assume it as anti-clockwise rotation. Okay, and it is about the origin. What will be the new vertex coordinates? Okay, so what we can do here is there will be two methods. One, we individually can calculate the rotation of these three points, and then we can say that okay, this is my final coordinate. Okay, so what is going to be the rotation equation of this matrix? For 30 degrees, we will be having cos 30 minus sin 30, then sin 30 cos 30. Okay, so that is going to be my this matrix, rotation matrix. Okay, I can calculate the values here. Now, in order to calculate rotation of 0, 0, I will apply it 0, 0, right, and I will calculate the values. But I need to do same thing three times. So what I can do is I will simply write the coordinates here itself in different columns. Okay, and now I will do the calculations. Okay, so this coordinate will get transformed in our first values, next one in next values, and next one is next values. Okay, so cos 30 minus sin 30 will get multiplied here, so it will be 0, 0. Again here it will become only cos 30, and for this one it will become only sin 30. Right, and here it will become basically a cos 30 minus sin 30, right? Cos 30 minus sin 30, and here it will become sin 30 plus cos 30. Okay, so finally what I'm having, that 0, 0 is converting into 0, 0 itself. Okay, 1, 0 is converting into cos 30, sin 30 means root 3 by 2, 1 by 2. Okay. And 1, 1 is getting converted into cos 30 minus sin 30, and root 3 minus 1 by 2, comma sin 30 plus cos 30, and root 3 1 plus 2. Okay. So these will be my final coordinates of that triangle. Okay. Then we may have a question, what will be the reflection coordinates? Okay. So reflection of 3, 4 about x axis and y axis, we have already done it. Okay. So if this is my point 3, 4, if I want to have the reflection about x axis, so it will become 3, -4. If I want to have a reflection about y-axis, then it will become -3, 4. Right? That is very simple. Okay. Then last question for this one. Is a triangle having vertices at 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, what will be the new coordinates after shear of 2 along x? So, the first case that we are having is shear of sx is equal to 2. And second case that we are having is sy of 2. Okay, and we have to apply the either we can apply our formula or we can use the matrix here. Okay, so if we apply the formula, then we know that x new in case of only x shear will be equal to x old plus sx into y old, right? And y new will be equal to y old only. And when we are applying a y shear, then we will be having x new is equal to x old only, and y new is equal to y old plus sy into x old, right? Now I can apply my values over here. So x new will become x old, because for each of these points we are going to do this thing. Okay, so let's say I'm doing it for 1, 1, right? So that will become x old, that is 1, plus sx is 2 into y old is 1, so this will become 3, and y dash will remain 1 only. So 1, 1 will get translated into 3, 1. Okay, and if I apply this y shear, then x new and x dash will be equal to x old, that is 1 only, and y dash will become y old. Y old means 1 plus sy is 2 into x old is 1, that is 3. So it will become 1, 3 as per this shear. Okay, I can apply the matrix also here. So when I talk about the matrix, then this is going to be the matrix of shear. Is when I am having x shear only, it will become 1, 2, and 0, 1, right? That is my matrix, and I have to apply it for these three points. Okay, so 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0. So I can simply do the multiplication over here and I will get 3, 1, 0, 0 and 1, 0. So my point 1, 1 has converted into 3, 1, 0, 0 has converted into 0, 0 and 1, 0 has converted into 1, 0. Okay. Similarly, I can apply in the same thing for y also. Okay. So I can write the y, the shear equation here. So that will give me 1, 0, 2 and 1, that is y shear, into my all the coordinates for which I want to do the transformation 1, 1, 0, 0 and 1, 0. And I can have my transformed coordinates as 1, 3, 0, 0 and 1, 2. Okay. So that is how we can apply either the matrix or the normal equations that we want to use. Okay. So in our next video, we are going to look at the homogeneous transformations and the mapping from one frame to another frame. Well, thank you for watching the video and best of luck for your exam.